Wherever there is money, inevitably there is corruption. Even in the early 1400s, car cheating existed, as referenced from an article from Paris in those times, where a card cheat was called a mechanic or card manipulator to manipulate the deck to gain an unfair advantage. And in 1876, American legend Wild Bill Hickok was accused of cheating and shot dead in the back of the head. And as he slumped in his chair, his poker hand was revealed as aces and eights, now known as Dead Man's Hand. In the 1965 classic movie, The Cincinnati Kid, clearly the element of gambling and cheating go hand in hand, as you can see in this following clip.
All right, to freshen up Mr. Williams' drink a little bit.
A little more bourbon, Mr. Williams?
Thank you, Mrs. Slade.
Now you just say when.
Oh, when? That's it. Thank you kindly, Mrs. Slade.
Honey, why don't you go out to the kitchen and bring us some of those fancy little hors d'oeuvres?
Why, that's exactly what I was about to do, sugar. I declare, Billy, sometimes I think you got psychic powers.
She's a real lady, Mrs. Slade.
That little gal means more to me than the whole wide world, Shooter. How's your Melba these days?
Melba? Well, she's fine, just fine.
Yeah, she's a nice girl, Melba. Girl of quality and taste. Expensive tastes, I would imagine.
Well, I guess you might say that, yes.
Well, that's as it should be. That's one of the great feminine characteristics, taste for fine things. Of course, we can't always afford to indulge their taste. That's the tragedy of it. That's when they start to drift away. You know this game that you're dealing for Lancey and the kid, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's an awful lot of interest developing in that game. Betting interest, that is. What would you figure the odds to be, Shooter?
Well, I'd say the New York money will probably lay about, 8-5 on Lancey.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, though, I think the kid's chances are better than that.
So do I. So do I. That's why I'm getting me down a bet. Big bet.
Well, I don't think I'd want to bet on it. Or the kid could take him if he's right, but I'd never bet on it.
Lancey Howard is an old man, Shooter. He's ready for a fall. Trouble is that the kid might be nervous. Big game like this, he may be off his form. He may need a little help, you know?
No, I don't. I don't quite know what you're
dealing the game, aren't you?
Yes, I'm dealing the game.
Well, I thought as long as I'm going to the trouble of putting a bet down for myself, I may as well get one down for you, too. Say, in the neighborhood of $25,000.
I could never do anything like that.
Of course you couldn't. That's why they chose you to give them a fair deal.
No, it's out of the question, Mr. Slade. You see, if I... I
Merci,
tell you, it's just out of the question. Sorry.
Well, the kid's not going to need much help, Shooter. Maybe two or three hands at the right time. Oh, Melba'd be mighty proud of you if you won yourself $25,000.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Slade.
Mm. Well, I'm sorry, too, Shooter, because you leave me no alternative but to remind you of the fact that I'm carrying these markers on you. $12,000 to be.
Those are legitimate markers, and you know it. You gave me 2 years to pay them.
Wait a minute. Just because I'm generous or foolish enough to accept your marker one day doesn't mean I'm going to recognize it the next. No, sir, no. That recognition is null and void if I happen to suddenly realize that you are not of sound mind.
And nothing had changed 30 or 40 years later when Rounders came out. It still showed that money and gambling and deceit and cheating go hand in hand.
Raise you. Come in. Wow. Wow. A lot of action. A lot of action.
flush.
Jesus. Who wants more? I'm in.
Okay.
Come on. Come on. Staging a late night comeback here. Late night rally. Okay? Just to warn you. Ace high bets.
Ace checks.
Check.
Check on an ace. All right. I'll check.
Check
it. Check, check.
Check.
All right, free card. Here we go. Fourth street.
Deck. Hold on there.
Whoa, easy. Easy. What are you doing?
Give me the deck.
What's the trouble? Stop. Relax, man. Don't get so agitated.
Looks like we got a rogue gang here.
A what? What are you? What?
Hey. What the hell's going on over here, Stu?
This son of a bitch is base dealing. Caught a hanger, Sarge.
What? A hanger? What are you saying? I don't even know what you're saying.
He's saying you're dealing off the bottom of the deck.
Oh, God. Come on, guys. Jesus.
What did he give him?
To me?
Seven of hearts.
You boys professionals? You working?
Hey, no. Listen. I was winning before this guy got here, all right?
Okay. Let's let the cards do the talking. If the seven didn't help you, we'll listen to what you have to say. Ozzy, turn the cards.
What? Hey, come on. It's three of a kind. You dealt Ozzy three
Shut
sixes
up.
Like... I'm just saying, it's three
One
of a kind.
One last thing, Stu.
Hey, all right, take it easy now. Aren't you supposed to, like, read us our rights, please?
And the movies don't hold a candle to cheating in reality, as the real-life cheating makes the movies look like kids from the kindergarten. If you remember the Ultimate Bet scandal with Russ Hamilton, who was a World Series of Poker champion, used an account called Pot Ripper to clean everyone out as he was working with site employees to see his opponent's cards. No police, no prison, no fines. Just get away with the money and pack it in. And then came the Full Tilt Poker scandal, which made Pot Ripper look like a micro-stakes bad reg. And who needs to cheat when, well, you just don't pay anybody their money and take all the money?
Again, you know, the hero of the story was also cheating. And that's just not... The heroes of poker don't cheat.
This piece of advice, or maybe, you know, one of the best observations, particularly in the poker world that I got, was from a player who once told me that honesty is the best.
And if Pot Ripper on Ultimate Bet wasn't enough, and if the Full Tilt Poker scam wasn't enough, then there's another poker site that was lucky not only to have one scandal, but multiple scandals, and still be able to be in operation.
That's sad to say. I mean, I know a lot of people care. Online community cares. Good players care. But bad players, they seem to not care if the rake is ridiculous. They seem to not care if the game is on the up and up. They seem to not care if there are bots in the game or people are using assistance or if people can see the cards. I'm getting to a point where I feel like as the breaking news guy that covers
And cheating didn't have to happen just online or behind closed doors. No. How about do it on a live stream in front of everybody just to show them how good you really are?
We will show you the moment that Mike Posel had decided to go to the dark side. He decided to become a professional crotch starer, and he decided to put his phone under the table to gain extra information and become one of the biggest winning players in the history of the 1-3 and 5-5 game at Stones Live Casino. That's right, Mike Posel has been accused of cheating by a former employee of Stones Live named Veronica. We have took...
And if one live streaming cheating event isn't big enough, let's go to a bigger stage with better cameras and bigger money and bigger players.
When are you utilizing...
You gotta take this class.
If he calls, there'd be about two pot sized bets left. So, I mean, that's what's got to be going through his head here. I think he's considering bet three betting. And, yep, there's the all in. There's the all in. Garrett, like I said, he's just so experienced in bet patterns, bet sizing. She sort of acted a little bit with Jack 8 of Diamonds from a few rounds ago. She's going to put a time chip out? She said that she thought Garrett had a draw about 20 minutes ago when Garrett had the full house, the queen four against Jack 8. And she took some time with it. And then she said,
I just want to call to see it. I think he might have me, though. Three's no good? This is why you shouldn't be in hands like this.
She doesn't have a three. So.
You want me to call you?
I don't know what she's thinking about here, because she loses to some bluffs like king, queen, queen, jack types of things too.
I
vote no.
I call.
She calls?
For once, but it's up to you. Yikes.
Oh my god.
Let's see the hand.
So far so good. It looks like you're ahead.
What is going on here?
For once, but it's up to you.
Is it possible that her hand might be misread in the card graphics or something?
Because I have a shitty hand.
You do? Yikes.
What
now? No, I just thought he's. I'm. This is a pure bluff catcher. I'm dealing with. Right now.
With Jack High.
But, yeah. I don't have. I think he has to be.
We'll go to the river. The river is a nine.
That one's you for sure.
They're gonna run it twice.
I don't think so.
She's
got a small pair.
Yeah, she's a three in the king.
You give me that much credit?
I don't know.
She's good with the first one.
Let's turn him over. You're
not that.
Yeah. No.
If the cards are correct.
What is the call?
What a sick car.
And the river bricks out again.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Take care.
I need. I want to see. Does she have Jack 4?
She had 4 Jack High.
What?
Whoa.
Look at.
Whoa.
What the fuck?
Whoa, that's, right, look at Garrett's face. That is.
That's a fucking poker right there.
That was sick.
Wow.
That's strong. That was sick.
One player even went and brought his own chips to the tournament. And when he was found out, he tried to flush them down the toilet. Now, last week, the World Series of Poker has come out. They're saying that they're banning chip riffling, right? What other better way to telegraph your hand strength to somebody at the table than riffling your chips? Riffle them a few times. You could send a whole telegraph better than Morse code.
Hey, I'm Nicky Numbers, professional poker player, and now I'm going to show you how to shuffle chips. You may have seen poker on TV, and you may have seen pros at the table doing something like this. Shuffling their chips while they're making a decision or while they're not in a hand. It's something that's very common at the poker table, something akin to shaking your leg. People do it nervously, people do it habitually, people just do it because it's fun to shuffle chips.
Cheesecake and strudel. For how much? What?
For how much?
Why, Nathan, I never knew you to lay money on the line. You always take your bite off the top.
$1,000 says that yesterday Mindy sold more strudel and cheesecake.
Nathan, let me tell you a story.
Have we got a bet?
On the day when I left home to make my way in the world, my daddy took me to one side. Son, my daddy says to me, I am sorry I'm not able to bankroll you to a very large start but not having the necessary letters to get you rolling. Instead, I'm going to stake you to some very valuable advice. One of these days in your travels, a guy is going to show you a brand new deck of cards on which the seal is not yet broken. Then this guy is going to offer to bet you that he can make the jack of spades jump out of this brand new deck of cards and squirt cider in your ear. But son, you do not accept this bet, because as sure as you stand there, you're going to wind up with an ear full of cider. Now, Nathan, I do not suggest that you have been clocking Mindy's cheesecake.
Would I do such a...